for waking up early with us. How many of y'all are on West Coast time with Jensen and me? Well, thank you guys.
Although I'm on East Coast time now. That's a trip. You don't sleep the night before. Power through the whole day, and then when it comes time to go to bed, last night, like, wow, I'm exhausted. And it's 9.
Very, very true. So far, so good. Everybody is. Welcome to the family. Welcome to our bizarre, awesome, supernatural family. We have been blasting through season 12. As y'all know, we're about to premiere on Thursday.
Yeah.
You're supposed to know this.
They just tell me where to stand and what to say.
Yeah, that's true. And he doesn't always do it. But we're thrilled. I think it's been one of those kind of crazy seasons. And we just got an email from Peter Roth, who's the head of Warner Brothers. And this thing is... Ashton? We got an email from Peter Roth, who's the head of our network, our studio, and just saying it's a really cool episode. He's really excited. So, tell me thank you guys. Before you just jibber jabber, let's see. You guys have been waiting a long time, so if anybody want to yell any questions or angry statements, yes. She raised her hand on angry statements, so a little nervous.
There will be a comment box later, yes, that we will destroy.
I actually have a
There's a mic in my face.
I have a question for both of you, actually. One is from my 7-year-old daughter. And who has a massive crush on you, thinks you're very handsome. Jared.
Sorry, when she grows up and matures, she'll be like,
she has great taste.
Yeah, I'm totally down there.
Sorry, good question. Next.
She actually wanted to know what made you start Supernatural, and I know it wasn't
the exact dream.
Started,
but... It's just a dream. I'm just
going to
snuggle.
And my question is, Jensen is my co-worker and friend from Dallas, right now, watching the Cowboys, and he wanted to know who is your favorite Cowboy.
Interesting.
Right now, Prescott.
I like you.
Apparently, we have a big New York Giants fan in the house here.
I didn't start Supernatural, obviously, but I think what attracted to me was the relationship with family. So, obviously, the connection between Sammy was something really cool and special. So, I'm glad that. Thank you, girl. I think you're coming. So, I have a crush on you, too. Scarf. There's a cool scarf
on this bat.
It's a scarf.
Or this bat.
I'm going to you next.
Further back. Well, there's one even further back.
Sorry, Pat.
Yeah.
If that is your real name.
Hi, I have watched your show since day one. I absolutely love you guys. Amazing, amazing 12 years. Oh my goodness. My question is, if you could have dinner with anyone, dead or alive, fictional or non-fictional, who would it be?
Wow.
My wife.
Oh. No.
But beyond that, if it wasn't my wife, because she would probably...
How about this? If you and Jen could have dinner with anybody.
If Jen could?
The two of you.
Oh.
I get her out of the equation.
You know, I would like to be my father's father. He died before I was born. My mom's parents are still alive, and they've been a part of my life. My father's mother passed season two of Supernatural, so I knew her, but I never got to meet his father. I thought it would be a cool thing to, yeah.
Yeah, his father's father. Someone, yeah, I probably could list quite a lot of people. I'm just gonna grab one of those names, Gandalf. I want to see this with me. Would make my dinner disappear or something. Granted, I probably would do that by myself.
The right amount of time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Scarf.
You.
No, you just did that one.
I was just appreciating the laugh, the courtesy laugh I was getting over.
Okay, I'm gonna mess up the name of this band because I can't say it, but Kaleo, thank you so much for introducing us to them because that album is killer. So, Jared, if you ever have any suggestions on bands, like, hand them over because we're clearly liking your
Justin Bieber?
As a Torontonian, I take offense to that.
Is he from Toronto? He is.
We like to share here.
What is the return policy on this? I'm pretty sure it's broken and the warrant is expired, but...
Yeah, so my question is... My question is, have you pitched for any Kaleo songs to be on Supernatural this season? If you have, which one?
No, not yet. But what would it be?
Yeah, what song
would it be? I do like the All the Pretty Girls. If you listen to the lyrics, it says All the Pretty Girls, like Samuel. Yeah, I don't know. There's plenty of shit
wrong. I personally think
Broken Bones would go. Broken Bones, yeah. I did just play a. And you might see this. Let me see if I can pull it up.
Just a picture. I know you can't do it.
I'm always kidding. I played a song for. Let's see. I was watching a commercial came on. I was like, "Who's that song?" And I was like, why the hell has that song never been on our show? I got it.
You knew that song.
Yeah, but it's never been on the show. Oh, we gotta sit through a 14-second ad now. No, I can't, this will let you.
I can.
Well, because you haven't updated your phone.
I did, it sucks.
In 9 years.
Wait, has the girl updated your PMI phones? I did. I can't figure out how to send a picture.
So that would have been a great song for Baby, but anyway, we're always going to keep our eyes out for stuff like that. So if you guys ever have any suggestions, please
call them.
Yeah,
512. Thanks. Just
what? The gentleman in the back.
How do you know he's gentle? He could be a real asshole.
No, not a man.
Okay, of course, I really enjoyed the show.
Thank you.
Like a lot of other shows, but some I don't like much. I keep having this recurring dream where Sam and Dean show up at Vampire Diaries, and in one episode, it's all over. My question is...
That's a waking dream.
I didn't say I was laying down my head. My question is, if you had to, and you had the choice, what show, if you had to cross over, past or present, would you like to see Sam and Dean show up on?
Walking Dead. Yeah! I'd be like, Sam, this Negan guy really looks like that. Again. Dad's still a honey trick. And he's got a new weapon. It's a bat.
That was a good answer.
Gilmore Girls. Rolling the Leafs Diner would be like, this coffee sucks.
Degrassi.
Oh, yes.
Once upon a time, there's like,
well, but we kill people.
Things, Dr. Sexy Andy. Yeah, like Dr. Who or something would be kind of fun. Plus, then you would have to listen to Mark Shepard talk about how he was on Dr. Who. Yeah, we're all on Dr. Who. So, I'm gonna go, you know, I saw way over there. Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
First of all, I have a question, but I also have a request. It's very, very short.
Okay. Like my friend? Our friend Rob. You gotta flip out. Yeah, but Sam also didn't know Mom, so it's kind of a cool, we get to see Sam be a son, he didn't really like his dad a whole lot. But we get to see Sam, and the funny thing, the irony is that it's kind of Mom's fault. I mean, she was the hunter, right? But we get to see Sam kind of be a son, as opposed to, you know, from the time we met Sam, he was an individual. He didn't want to be part of the family business, he didn't want to be part of this, he wanted to kind of go off on his own. So we get to see Sam kind of in a different dynamic. But that was your question, not your request. I'm scared.
And,
I
Jensen.
Hi.
Can you do your scream and your line, that was scary
for it was too early. You want to hear me scream. Right. I don't even know if I can do that anymore. Talking about the scary cat, right?
Yeah. Think of a morning without
even yourself.
What's funny is he does it more than I do. You're always doing the. There. That's all I can muster right now. Maybe later.
That's his line.
What?
Line.
Can you do it standing on one foot?
Dance, monkey, dance! Pay good money!
That was scary.
All right. How about... Yeah, all right.
Alright, first of all, go Eagles.
What was that?
Go Eagles.
Oh. I thought you said goalie goes. I don't know what that means.
It's Toronto.
What? It's Toronto.
Why are you an Eagles fan?
Because I'm from Philly. And, you know.
Alright.
Philadelphia
wins. That makes sense.
We'll see how it goes this year.
What's that?
Philadelphia wins Sylvania. So we'll see how it goes. I also have tips for you guys, just saying that. And then I was wondering if when the show, if
and when the show finally ends.
Uh-oh.
It might not. If it ends, would you guys consider continuing conventions, kind of like how Shatner does for Star Trek and stuff?
You should.
Yeah, we talked about that. I don't know, maybe not as many, but because then we'll be actively looking for other work.
Begging for jobs.
Yeah. but we do really enjoy this. So. Yeah.
It's also part of what makes literally the filming of Supernatural not so onerous and burdensome. It's getting to get really excited in these new cool cities, these new cool, I guess, provinces now. But it can get pretty Friday. We start at 11:30 a.m., which means we're getting there at 11 a.m., which means we're getting picked up at 10, and filming straight till 2 o'clock, and it's kind of, no matter how much you love what you're doing, it's tiresome. You know, when the sun goes down at 6 o'clock and you have 8 hours left of work and you've been there for 6 hours, that's how I feel. You got me. So you get, and we're older than we were 12 years ago, so it's more difficult to stay awake and be alert at 2 o'clock. And you find yourself
like, I'm sure you have stayed the same age.
Yes, you have. Yes, you have.
One of the things that makes that worthwhile is getting to see firsthand. Because, I mean, he and I both live in Austin, Texas. So we're in Vancouver filming, and we're in Austin that has nothing to do with the entertainment industry. So we don't get to often see the fruits of our labor. I would rather come to a convention than watch an episode of the show. This excites me more than watching the show. You know, I know what happens in the show. So being here and feeling the excitement is part of what makes it all worthwhile. So.
Cool. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
And who do you think could win a push-up contest?
Cliff.
Yeah. I read my scripts on the treadmill. And just many years ago, I kind of have, I don't know, part of having anxiety or something. I have a lot of nervous energy. And so I found out many years ago that literally
a lot of,
yeah. That's how he stays in shape. Running on the treadmill, reading my scripts helps me focus on the lines coming up. So I'll do that, but I do a lot of things.
Yeah, I varied up a lot of jogging. We'll do these like workout videos, like
jazzercise.
Yeah.
Tracy Anderson,
Jane Fonda, you heard of it? Swimming with goldies. Yeah. Super Richard Simmons. But you know, it's those socks that get really warm when your leg warmers.
Yeah.
The insanity videos, P90X stuff. Like, because that's easy to do, it's quick. Like I did one.
It's not easy to do.
Well, I would say it's convenient to do.
It's not convenient to do.
But it sucks. Did one this morning in the hotel room, you know? It was like, boom, knocked out 20 minutes.
No, I didn't.
Moving on.
I gotta say though, I'm pretty good at push-ups.
I put money on him, he's bigger. Of course, that means he's got more weight to lift.
What about you? What do you do this next year?
In the last year, I got certified to teach Taibo. So I've been teaching Taibo for the last year.
Nice. Very cool. I love that. It keeps you distracted, right?
They have videos too. You can try that.
That's right. I don't know if I'm not even that good a shape.
How about, yes, right here in the front row.
Do you ever have any accidents with your props, like squibs or anything like that
Friday night, we actually, yesterday morning, if you want to be technical about it, this is about 1 a.m.,
Some poor name in Toronto.
But there was supposed to be, we had a young lady guest star on the show, Courtney, and there's a mirror above her that's supposed to crack. And it didn't crack, it exploded. Glass went all over her face,
oh my hair. Gosh.
Luckily, she was a good sport about it. I mean, she did get injured, but they had to like sit there and pick glass out of her hair. That's, they generally put like a Mylar film over the mirror so that it won't blow out like that. It'll just crack and it'll get saved. But I guess, I don't know whether that particular one they put the film on or the film was weak and it broke open, but yeah, we've had, I mean, it's...
And a fire. And there's something touching
on
fire.
Yeah, and, yeah. And the... Misha has, he's holding something that, that kind of...
combusts.
Combusts, self-combusts, and it gets on fire. And I reach over and I grab a trash can, and he just throws it in there, and then I pour a pitcher of water on it. But the way that it, the way that the item landed in the trash can, all of the flames were just coming up my arm.
Oh my.
And so, in the mid, take, so I reach
it'll,
over.
It'll make the gag reel, don't worry.
So boom, he throws it in there, and I realize, and I'm just supposed to be like,
I'm burning.
And I realize, oh, that's, my thumb is like in the fire right now. And so I basically the reenactment was like, it's, it was like, and I kept cool in the face, but there was certainly a body language, slight body language of panic that happened. It was like, I got here's, and then I turn around and I put the trash can down and we go on the scene. And this is,
I'm giving something to double as a trash can because that was an incorrect impression. Here's our trash can. So the scene deems being real cool. Something catches on fire, and Dean kind of like walks in the corner and grabs a trash can.
What is that walk?
Holds up the garbage can to Castiel. Castiel throws the thing in, and he's like, I'm on fire.
So, cut to, I think I pour the water in the can, I set it down. And I step back, Jared's standing here, I'm standing right here, the cameras are pointed at us, and I see Jared just do this. And he's like, turn the other way. And I'm kind of out of the corner of my eye going like, what is he doing? He didn't do that in the last shot. I'm like, he's still looking, he's probably looking at the trash can, he's probably on fire behind him. And he's making sure that the it actually went, no, he's hysterically laughing. All the while, the scene's still going on, like, there's still dialogue being, and I'm actually saying stuff, but my mind is not, my mind is wondering, what the hell is he doing next to me? And I finally am like, what? And he turns around, and it's just tears. And he's like, beet red, I'm like, what? And he's like,
no one else saw it, but I know him so well.
He knows you so well that he saw just that slight little brief, like, he knew that was not Dean anymore. That was Jensen trying to save his hand from being burned.
I think the honesty, and this sounds bad, but the honest, like, startled surprise just makes me laugh. Like, people are scared or something. I'm like, oh, this is fun and scary, but the startle response, for some reason, makes me laugh. And so seeing it on Jensen, like, yeah, I'm on fire. Right in the middle of the scene. And like you said, it's a pretty intense scene. And so our young guest star is talking, and a few of our other stars are talking, and I'm like, I'm gonna ruin this.
Yeah, so instead of like just saying, I'm sorry, I'm laughing, he just... just puts his back to the camera, as if that's gonna save the scene.
So it happened twice yesterday, alone, so.
But yeah, props and
you have a nice chunk of finger taken off.
Yeah, my Colt, I was loading it, and the receiver snapped back and took my finger, the meat of my finger, and just took it right off. and it was right as they yelled action. It was like action, I racked the gun, and then my finger was in, I was like, I pulled it out, and then I could just feel this flap of skin. And so I was like, okay, well that sucks. So I literally just thumbed the flap back down and held it like that for the rest of the scene. And then I looked down, and there was just like blood just like dripping on my head. I'm like, okay, well, I guess I didn't hide that as well. I still have a nice little scar on that. But yeah, stuff like that. I mean, over 12 years, constantly dealing with those kind of things, special effects, squibs, guns,
rusty cars,
blowing up things, self-combusting, fire. There's, you know, luckily nobody's ever been seriously injured.
Season 4, the glass, the real glass.
Oh, when Dean comes back from hell, beginning of season 4, and the angel voices, or they blow all the glass blows at that little gas station. Kim Vander said that'd be a great idea to use real glass. And so I had to like lay down, I don't know if you ever laid down in tempered glass before, but it essentially slices you open. So I look down and my hands are just, my forearms are all just sliced up. And I'm like, Oh. And so we were like picking glass shards out of my arm. But again, I feel that it was fine. There was no serious damage. So nobody's been seriously hurt. You snapped your wrist.
Snapped my wrist. There's a legitimate piece of my scalp in the prop lockup from the episode when the guy's drinking bleach because one of the bad guys is telling him, one of the seven sins or something, is telling him to drink bleach. And we have to, again, it was Kim Manners, and he was like, get into the car faster! Because Bobby drives his Chevelle through. And I was like, well, Kim, I'm 6'4", and I'm diving in the back with, all right. And so it's like, all right, action. And we run, and I'm kind of like doing my little tie bow to get into the back. And I keep banging my head on the top, and I'm like, whatever. Like, I'm trying to get all of me into a little in the back seat. And I was like, I'll just deal with it. And finally, my hair lady, Jeannie Chow, comes up, and she's doing this number, like, fluffing my hair a little bit. And then she looks at me, and she goes, what? She has sheer panic in her eyes. And then she goes like this, and looks in, like, you know, a clump of hair and a piece of my scalp.
I just love that he didn't even feel it. Like,
listen, when you're this tall, you hit your head on stuff a lot. People freak out, I'll hit my head on something, and they're like,
he really is a moose. Fine. Like, just like, oh, my scalp, oh, my brain is exposed.
Oh, the cane knife, when he gets done with cane and comes down from the barn, and he's got, so when we have knives and blades, they're dull on the edge, but the tip is still a point, it's still sharp.
Still do damage.
Yeah, it can still do damage. And so he comes in, and he collapses, right? And I kept on...
I had it in my, like, left hand.
Yeah.
And literally, I felt as soon as it, I was like, oh, that just went to his leg.
And so we hold it, and it's like the camera is like on the hub.
I was like, certainly he's hurting right now.
And then he's just like, oh, fuck. Because, like, dude.
There's a knife in his leg.
As soon as they call cut, sure enough, there's a rip in my pant, and my knee got cut open. So it was like blood on my hand. And I was like, oh, huh. And like, well, we're not seeing it in the shot. I was like, all right, so I had to roll my pant leg up and wrap some gauze around it. But it was like sticking to my legs.
I'm like, did you feel that?
Feel what? He's like, there's
a door here. Too many doors.
It's part of the fun.
Anyway, yeah, we've got plenty of stories about things not going as planned. But
I'll go right here.
So my question is, what was the most challenging episode you had to film?
It's a good question.
I would say recent. I mean, we've had a lot of challenging ones, a lot of challenging parts of episodes, but I would say a collective episode, I would say maybe last year.
For you?
And also lights and stuff like that. For me certainly, but also on a technical aspect, just figuring out how we're going to film it in that style was very technically challenging for our crew, because the camera operators weren't going to be operating cameras, and the sound guys weren't going to be holding the boom over us, and everything was like attached to the car, and were smaller, we were using different cameras, so they had to figure those out. And then I had to essentially like turn all the cameras on and slate them, and it was like a one-man show, but it was, well, or a two-man show when you're using the car. And that was very challenging, both kind of physically and technically. But again, we've had tons of challenging shows.
Off the top of my head, I can't remember what the episode, which one it was, but it was one of the season finales where Sam has like, Sam and Soulless Sam, or Sam and Lucifer Sam, and Sam and Hell Sam, so they're like a
wait,
lot.
Wait, what?
Sam has to go Sam. And kill the other Sam. Yeah, we used to get rid of, like, and so when I've had to do different characters in the past, it's been easier, like if it was Gabriel or Soulless Sam, or when the Meg Demon possessed me. It's easier to focus because you just kind of commit to that, but when you're doing a scene and you're playing opposite yourself, it's weird, because also my stuntman, who I love to death, Mike Carpy, he's awesome, and he's studied, but still, like, you don't, and we always have our prop girl, Robin, read all camera dialogue, because she reads it in, like, the perfect monotone, where, because if somebody says to me, like, what do you think you're doing? Then I'm going to respond, like, oh, I'm just blah, blah, blah. But she'll do it in such a way where she's like, what do you think you're doing? Like, she just kind of says it to where I can then do what I know I'm going to do. I can respond to what I know I'm going to do as opposed to responding to what they're doing. So a scene where you don't know yet what you're going to do on the other side, and but you're having to kind of respond to it, and then go do the other side, you're like, well, God, how do I react to this line? So I can't say a line like this. That was kind of a cluster bad word. cluster bad word. It was fine. So.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think that was it for us, guys. We are going to see y'all soon. Thank you so much for coming out.
Thanks for being here, guys.